Well, we'll be moving to level 3, which for most people will look a lot like level 4. We'll stay there for 2 weeks, and then the government will decide whether or not we go down to level 2, stay on level 3, or go back to level 4. So what does this mean for our Pacific community? Here's the Minister for Pacific Peoples, Aupito William Sio, and what he had to say.
We're not returning to normal. We're not rushing into normality. This is a transition phase. And so if I describe alert level 4 as being stay at home and only go out when it's absolutely essential, then alert level 3 is stay at home and only go out when it's absolutely safe. And so I think we've got to also accept the fact that we cannot go back to the normality that we understood and lived by pre-COVID-19. We cannot go back to the normal that we've been accustomed to, whether it's family, church, or business. This is a whole new world that we've got to embrace at the moment, which offers up opportunities, but it will be quite challenging for some.
In terms of listening to how people have coped during the lockdown, what have you heard from people and how difficult that has to change to this new behaviour? What kind of feedback have you had?
I think it's been, there's some really positive stories on this. You know, everybody's now doing these Zoom family meetings. My dad, who's 82, he's a Zoom fan. So it's really been an exciting adventure for many families. I've been listening to a number of church ministers give their sermons on a weekly basis, and all I've got to do is flick on Facebook and move from page to page.
How concerned are you that our people will, I guess, start to, you know, break their bubbles, gather in family groups perhaps, or go visiting each other more once it changes to level 3?
I mean, the danger exists. It's because we're only humans and nobody's perfect. And also because the government's approach is based on trust. And that approach means that we're giving all of New Zealanders up-to-date information. We're giving them the tools and techniques. We're giving them the data to help them make decisions. But we're giving them the trust to be able to follow the approach that we're asking all New Zealanders to do. And so far, that collective approach has shown that we can all do as long as we're working together.
So the reason why we're going down to level 3 is because our infection rates have dropped significantly. Now this week, the Ministry of Health announced that 66 Pacific people in New Zealand have COVID-19. I talked with Dr. Api Talemaitoga to hear his thoughts about this.
Yes, the numbers have remained relatively stable and low at around 60 or 4.6% of the number of people that have tested positive. That is good, but I don't want us to be complacent, because if we just let go of all the good advice and the restrictions that we put in place, we can really endanger this virus with the community transmission.
Can you explain what contact tracing is and how important that is in protecting people during the COVID-19?
That's a really good concept to discuss, because contact tracing is difficult. It's what public health units were set up for, is where they contact everybody who's been in contact with a person that's unwell or proved positive. So if you are in the same household, or maybe you work together, or you went to school together, then contact tracing is trying to find out who else might have been exposed to the virus like you were.
So under level 4 or during lockdown, it might have been quite easy to get in touch with people. How much difficult will it be moving into level 3?
I'm hoping that if we are good at our contact tracing work, especially if we use our Pacific health professionals to contact these Pacific families, we may be able to contact trace everybody. it's not going to be easy once we ease the restrictions. People might move about more, maybe going back to work. Some people will do that in level three. So it will have its challenges. I think we are concerned with what we're calling the surge that will happen after lockdown, both for physical and mental health. So for physical health, unfortunately, some of our communities have heard stay at home and neglected their physical health. Please go to your doctors or go to hospital if you are unwell. The health centers and the hospitals are still open. But the second important thing is what we're calling psychosocial or mental health issues. The issues of loneliness because of the inability to mix with other families. The issues of anxiety and fear that now someone's going to break the bubble from home and go to work in level three. Will they bring back the virus? We need to be aware within our families, particularly with our older people, that this is something they might be worried about, and to reassure them.
Awesome. Thank you for that. Thank you for your time on the show today.
You're welcome. Thank you, Marama.